Coming off a winter that barely felt like actual winter at all, Chicago and many other cities across the country broke all sorts of weather records this last season. Big questions come into play about if these are new normals for us or just part of a temporary trend.
Meteorologist Tim Joyce takes us to the Museum of Science and Industry, where you can ask those questions and you can find answers.
Chicago is home to the Western Hemisphere's largest science museum, and in a world where the weather seems to be getting weirder and wilder, it's a place where folks of all ages can and are going to look for answers about what's happening and why. And for decades, Patricia Ward has been one of many people behind the scenes making that happen at the Museum of Science and Industry.
There's no age limit on learning or inspiration or inventive genius. All of these things are so important at every stage of your life.
Dr. Patricia Ward found her love of science in biology class in high school.
Yeah, knowledge can be power. It also, as you said, it also can make people feel a little bit afraid.
And since 1999, this University of Chicago doctoral grad didn't go too far to get her full-time gig at Chicago's Museum of Science and Industry.
It is absolutely amazing. I mean, when you come out here and walk around, we call it the floor, the museum floor, and see people interacting, that's who we're doing this for.
But the other hope here is to get visitors to become more science literate when they leave, especially about things like climate change.
Global warming, climate change, these are sort of broad statements that are a little hard to understand. Global weirding. Weird things are happening, and they're happening with more frequency and more severity. So more frequent storms, more severe storms, these are things that are happening.
Chicago's weather has been changing, just like the rest of the planet. In data compiled by nonprofit Climate Central, winter is our fastest warming season. And this past winter was the fifth warmest on record. Unless you were born before 1931, last winter here was the warmest winter of your life. Great Lakes ice was the lowest ever recorded, only 3% for the season, a stunning value considering the average since 1973 has been about 40% of coverage. Chance of a white Christmas is going down, and both this year and last, our seasonal snowfall totals have been about half of average. And not only is more of our precipitation coming down in the form of rain, but it's coming down in heavier downpours as well, which raises the risk of localized flooding.
And I think what we've seen here at the museum is the people that are coming here that we talk to about these questions, they understand that. They see that things are changing.
Data shows spring average temperatures here are up more than 1.5 degrees, which doesn't seem like much, but it translates to a growing season, an allergy season that lasts about 2 weeks longer and starts earlier. Warmer temperatures in the fall means allergy seasons last longer and many more days of mosquito season too, about a month more of mosquitoes. And an estimated 938,000 people in these red areas showing our urban heat island effect suffer from temperatures in their neighborhoods 9 degrees warmer than rural areas. And if they can't afford AC, they face a greater risk of heat exhaustion and heat stroke when the body can't cool down while they're sleeping. Something we found out all too well when more than 700 people died in our 1995 heat wave in Chicagoland.
So within our exhibits, we try to ground them in things that we understand and that helps people understand a basic connection with the world, with the natural world and how it works.
One of the newest exhibits at the museum, Dr. Ward, had a major hand in creating. It's a completely immersive experience like you're walking underwater. And you find out one of the ingredients that is helping make our modern world is also destroying it and invading our bodies as well. We'll take you on a guided tour coming up next weekend. I'm Tim Joyce, WGN News.